It's time for this week's episode of Brandon Sports Talk, featuring in-depth interviews from those who are trending in the world of athletics. And now, here's the host of Brandon Sports Talk, Brandon Pate.
Welcome back to Brandon Sports Talk. In today's episode, I have the privilege to interview the amazing podcast, The Rookie Contract. How are y'all doing today?
Doing fantastic, Brandon. How are you doing?
We are doing great. Thriving out here.
Can you talk about how y'all got started being a sports talk podcast?
Dakota, this is all you. He was the brains behind this whole operation.
Yeah, so I'm still technically employed with sports as a job, and kind of when I was onboarding, when I was joining, I talked about wanting to do a podcast. It was more or less like wanting to do it with some friends, and I was just asking Colby like for some tips because he has, you know, his sports as a job podcast. I knew that he knew the kind of direction that podcasts go. He knew how to kind of start it up from the bottom. And so I was just talking to him about that. And then COVID hit, a few job opportunities I had went kind of down the toilet. So I was like, well, like, I still want to be engaged. I still want to be active. I still want to like do things. So I texted Colby and I was like, hey, remember that podcast? Like, how about we do a sports as job podcast? We're like, because the thing with sports as job is I was interviewing a lot of people that were kind of in their career for a little bit, and a lot of, like, not a lot of them, but a few of them were like, you know, I didn't even have internships, I just knew a person and got the job. And I was like, okay, well, you know, that doesn't make the best story. So so I was like, well, what if we start talking to younger people, because I kind of noticed our demographic was a little younger, and, you know, some people that they could relate to a little bit more. So I texted Kate and I was just like, hey, like, you want to do a podcast? We'll be, you know, I don't have all of the details yet. I'm still kind of working on it, but, you know, just getting stories from people within their first 4 years of, or that actually wasn't even a part of it yet. Yeah. I was just like, want to do a podcast.
Just kind of like went off of like this idea, and it just kind of started spitballing into this whole thing. It's been like an amazing experience to learn from other people on their experiences. And I'm like, yeah, hey, this is achievable. All right.
That's so amazing.
It was just, it was really fun to hear. I mean, it still is something that we do just for fun, at least on my end. Mm-hmm. I can't speak for Kate, but
it is really fun. This has been super fun. Like, I was literally talking about this the other day with someone. He was like, so what have you been doing throughout this pandemic? And I was like, I'm actually a part of a podcast. And he was like, that's really cool. And I'm like, hey. So I was like, you know, anytime I have the plan to plug that, we plug it.
Can you, Dakota, can you talk about how you came up with the name The Rookie Contract?
Yeah. So Kate and I were bouncing name ideas. This was a little bit after we were talking like about starting a podcast. And to be honest, I'm going to probably give
there
away
were like a list of names.
Yeah, there were a list of names, some a lot better than the other. But so I was playing Madden with some friends, and like we were doing a franchise thing. And so like you sign your rookies, like you have to do your rookie signings and everything. And I noticed that all of them, like I kind of didn't notice this before, but like rookie contracts, at least in the NFL, are 4 years long. And I was like, okay, well, we wanted to talk to people that like were younger. These rookies are pretty young, and like we want to have a cutoff point, because that was one of the things, is we're like, well, you know, how long are we going to talk, or how into their career do we want them to be? And so I was like, well, snap, like, what if we just call it The Rookie Contract, because it's like 4 years into the industry. I feel like, I don't know, Kate, you can touch on this too, but I feel like that's the that's the right amount of time, because, you know, we get people that are either, you know, in their first year where they're kind of just getting their foot in the door, or we get people that have kind of been, you know, their foot and maybe their leg is in the door now. So they're able to kind of,
if we just want to make a podcast where people just starting out and people that are still in school, like, have something to hear from, where it's not just, hey, I'm by myself. Like, no, you have like a whole community of these people, like, on the same path. It's truly amazing to see all of this kind of come from essentially nothing. We're just out here making this happen. So it's a great thing that we've been able to kind of accomplish.
And one final thing that I want to add is that, like, I guess the reason that we wanted to speak with people that were younger is because, like, they're excited, you know, they're excited to tell their story. People that work in sports, you know, really love working in sports, and not that that love, you know, gets lost when they're a little older or they're a little bit more into their career, but, you know, these people that we've been able to talk to, like, they're very, very excited to, like, talk about how they work in sports. They're doing a lot of things that people would kill to do at their age.
Yeah, especially so just going off of that, it's like how people have these, like, you were saying, these journeys. Yeah. Like, they're not always, like, cookie cutter, like, oh, like, I'm going to get a job right out of college. Like, no, that's not how it works. You have to go through, like, many different, like, things just to get to somewhere where you can get seen. So it's really interesting and honestly really great to be able to hear from people that have been in the similar situation that I am, Dakota's been in. And, you know, everyone is just kind of, like, excited to learn about that.
That's so wonderful. Kate, can you talk about some of the people that you've interviewed?
Yes. So I was actually talking about this the other day with someone that I was, you know, plugging the podcast. He was like, who has been the most influential person that you've interviewed? And I was like, it's really hard to, like, limit just one.
Yeah.
But there's been, like, a couple that have really stuck out to me. Our last podcast that we just, like, you know, uploaded the other on Monday, Richard, don't want to butcher his last name. What is it? Hoke.
Yeah, I know. It doesn't look like it.
Sorry, Richard, if you're listening to this, you're great. No, but he had, like, one of the best stories. Like, he was a really great storyteller, and he's really struggled with a lot of different things, but he's remained, like, very patient throughout the whole process. And I think that's what made everything super, I guess, real, even though, like, nothing was going to his plan. You just kind of stay consistent in your work and just got to keep on getting after it. And he's probably been, like, the most, like, inspiring for me, because hearing that story, I'm just like, you know, it's not the end of the road. Like, you just got to keep going. Don't listen to what everyone else says. Yeah, it's just like people like that kind of just make me more excited about working in the sports industry.
Kate, can you talk about how you come up with some of the people that you've interviewed?
So that's a really good question. So like, basically through our Twitters is essentially how we've gotten the majority of our people, through direct messages on LinkedIn, just people messaging us saying that they're eager to want to talk, which is pretty amazing, the amount of people that we've been able to actually get from just a small thing that we've been doing. And they're like, hey, I want to talk about my experience. I'm like, all right, let's do it. Let's make it happen. Yeah. And then we started, Dakota made all these social accounts, and, like, they've been popping off. You know, no me to, like, get us on, but yeah, it's great to see, like, just a small thing just kind of make other people excited, when it really, like, was, like, the whole premise was just to get other people, you know, excited and help each other. Like, that was the whole thing. It was like, hey, we're here for each other, especially in the sports industry where it's all about, you know, the journey of who you know, not like what mm-hmm. you know. So it's really great to have that network of people around you.
Dakota, when it comes to the people that you interview, can you talk about the process between getting the interviews? Like, for example, I know sometimes I have to deal with SIDs and compliance officers when it comes to coaches. What is the what do y'all have to deal with when it comes to that?
So thankfully, you know, similar with the Cutback Pod, we're not there yet. We haven't had to go through many people yet. For the most part, I mean, at least on my side, you know, when we started the podcast, the first thing that we made was a Twitter. And mm-hmm. I think this was from my personal Twitter. I just kind of said like, hey, thinking about starting a podcast.
Yes.
If any of you are interested in, you know, sharing your story, I want to get some, you know, feedback beforehand. And honestly, that was kind of what set us up, I think. Because, you know, Kate and I, probably between the two of us, got 50 plus people that were interested to tell their story. And that's the thing, is people like to tell their story, and we want to give an outlet for people to tell those stories. But yeah, I mean, in terms of getting the people on, it's mainly just reaching out to them through, you know, social media. I know I love LinkedIn. Like, I'll sit, I actually reached into my network from when I was being a writer for Sports as a Job. Mm-hmm. Anyone that I didn't get, you know, that I didn't think would work for an article, just because I didn't really know, I was pretty young, still learning about that. And so I'm like, well, I haven't reached out to them for an article yet. Maybe they'd want to be on the podcast. So just utilizing the network I've gotten. And, you know, Kate has a bigger Twitter following than I do. She knows Twitter a little bit better than me. So
I'm the
I let
Twitter
her handle
person,
Twitter.
He's LinkedIn. Yeah, we yeah, make it work.
Yeah. So we kind of feed off of each other's strengths and let whoever is stronger in one area handle that. and then vice versa.
Can you talk about, of course, the process of getting people on LinkedIn? Because I know just recently that's what I've done, where getting some of the professional coaches that I've got, mm-hmm. I use LinkedIn.
Yeah, LinkedIn is super crucial. I will always be an advocate for LinkedIn. I haven't been on it in the last like 24 hours though.
Wow.
So anyone,
that's,
I know, it's
crazy.
I'm getting the shakes, but
are you okay?
not really. But no, I mean, I'll use an example that's a little easier to learn you up that way. But so, I mean, if you want to reach out to a coach, just basically what I like to do is lay out the foundation of why I'm reaching out to them. And then, you know, always being very, you know, mannerful. I think that's a word. Just basically treating them with respect. And just being professional. So, I mean, anytime I send a connection, no matter pretty much whoever, unless I know them and they know me, sending a note with every connection, making sure to show them how you know them. And if you don't know them already, why you want to get to know them. I think that's really important. And then there's a cool feature that I don't know if everyone knows of, or I guess I don't know if it's a feature, but like for me, going into different teams of like people that I think I'd want to talk to. So if I notice that they have like a cool social feed, you know, I'll go to their LinkedIn page, then I'll go under people, and then it'll show like everyone that works with them that at least puts it on their LinkedIn. And you can kind of just go through like
that's
so I love the Chicago Bears, as you might be able to tell. They don't love me back, but it's basically like
a Fool's
going,
jersey though, right?
No, I don't need anything anymore. I'm done.
Oh.
Monday was terrible. But yeah, I mean, it's just like using that feature, I'm able to see, like, even if it's perspective, like job offers, you know, talking to people that are in certain job markets that I'd want to be in, just using that. And the last thing I'll say is reaching out to your own network. So, you know, let's just say Kate and I don't actually know each other. I could reach out to her and be like, hey, I see you're connected with so-and-so. Would you mind either, you know, giving me a recommendation to talking to them, or, you know, bridging the gap between the two of us. So, you know, that was something I wasn't always comfortable doing, but through the podcast, I would say I've definitely gotten more comfortable with just reaching out to people that I don't know. The worst that they could say is no, usually. So, it's just kind of getting comfortable reaching out to people.
That's amazing. Kate, who are some of the future people that you plan on interviewing on the rookie contract? My
gosh. Be careful,
Kate. Put me on the spot. That is a really good question.
I have the list right here if you don't.
Well, obviously, in this field, there's an incredible amount of people out here. Probably one of the most influential people that I think would be a great benefit to this podcast. Let me make sure her title, because I don't want to like... But this is a tricky one. We came into dangerous territory because how do I limit myself to one person, you know?
Digging yourself out, I like it.
Oh gosh, I know. Hold on a second.
In terms of people that like we have planned, mm-hmm. you know, we at one point may or may not have bitten off a little bit more than we can chew. In terms of interviews, we would schedule like 3 to 4 a week, and you know, I do have one person.
Okay, so there's this
time. You're good.
You know, it's all right. She orally.
Ooh. Orlos.
No, Oreos. can't pronounce that. Orioles.
There we go.
Yes. Her name is Melanie Newman, and she's pretty incredible. I would love to talk to her. She's like probably about 5 or so years into her career, but she's literally told me that she started bartending. She just like made enough money to not be at poverty. And she's like she's working for like this MLB team. And I'm like, what? Like something's not right there. But yeah. She literally works like it's nothing. And I'm like, I want to be here. That's incredible. So if I could get her on the podcast, that would be fantastic.
Dakota, can you talk about, of course, like with y'all working with professional people and stuff like that, do you have to, of course, go through like in college, there's compliance officers, but do you have to go through like the public relations people?
So actually, we had to do that 1 or 2 times. Well, we didn't have to per se, but there was someone with an NFL team that we were speaking with, and just because they, you know, it was good on them. They had kind of stricter PR just to make sure that, you know, they didn't come on the podcast and just start cussing a storm or something. But I mean, we haven't had to necessarily, but there have been times where I've had to like send the questions beforehand and kind of just give out the kind of why I was reaching out to them and what we were planning on doing. And then there have been a few times where I've had to send the audio beforehand or, you know, if there was something that they said that they weren't too happy about, like just cutting some parts out. But really for the most part, we've had a lot of good, you know, no problems or anything like that. So, as of now, I haven't had to necessarily speak to anyone like in PR, but I have had some people that are like, hey, can you send this to me beforehand? Like, I need to send it to my boss, which I'm totally cool with. I usually try to have this stuff done before Monday anyway. So, but yeah, I mean, that's definitely going to be hopefully an issue we fall into eventually. But as of now, it's not been too crucial.
Yeah.
What about you, Kate? Have you ran into the problem with PR and compliance officers?
Not particularly. Yeah, no. Yeah, like Dakota was saying, we've maybe come into a few where they were just, you know, concerned of what they said, but other than that, it hasn't like been like a huge issue so far, but I'm sure down the road it's gonna become more of like a bigger deal. So we're just super mindful of like what we say and like make sure that they are comfortable with discussing whatever it may be.
What are some future plans when it comes to the rookie contract?
So I know that Kate and I were talking about it a few weeks ago, maybe, but one of the ideas that we wanted to do was kind of like a where they are now, and more specifically with the people that are like free agents. So I think it would be really cool to like, for example, Daniel Salazar, he's one of the episodes that we have that was like a free agent. He's super awesome. I cannot like, he's one of the nicest people I've met. But I think it would be cool to kind of do a series of like where they are now. I know that, I don't know when, but TBD, Kate and I will be kind of discussing our own stories. I know that there's been a little bit of interest in that, kind of learning where we, you know, where we go, how we, I don't know, Kate, are you still in your rookie contract?
Absolutely. Yes.
Okay. I thought so. I know I am.
We'll be for a while.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that I am.
Yeah. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I'm like 99% sure I am. But I think that it would be.
I have no career yet, but we're getting there.
True, we're getting there. in terms of career, I'm still undrafted. But
we'll get drafted, don't worry.
Yeah, I'll take it. I'll take a backup spot for now, then work my way up. But yeah.
Tryouts next year.
Oh, actually, another thing.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. I'm trying to make it funny.
Crap, what is it called? Like the live streams. We were going to do some of those where like we did a little Q&A type deal.
That'd be cool.
But we're just kind of waiting to get a bigger social following so that way when we do that, it wouldn't just be like the two of us chilling.
Yeah, we're like, hey, we're talking to ourselves.
Yeah, so we're kind of letting everything grow organically. You know, I'm not putting money into it. Kate's not putting money into it. We're just doing it for fun. I mean, the only money I put into it was a mic, so like I'll take that investment. But I mean, just another thing is just you know, developing the podcast as it goes. I mean, something we did this week or this episode was, or episode 13, I guess. I don't know when. Yeah, I know. Was like releasing new cover art or album art. So that way, you know, we could make each episode a little bit more personalized. I'm not going to lie, I got that idea from Billy Quatch. He has his own podcast, Get the Shot. He kind of inspired me on that because his album art changes with each episode. So shouts out Billy. But in terms of things that I can release so far, those are the few things. But I don't know, Kate, do you have any I know you had some ideas potentially, but I might have said,
I mean, like, of course, once we have more of like a following, I guess, like you were saying, like the whole live streams and all that, the Q&As, I feel like once we kick off more, get some Instagram lives going, some more in-depth stuff of like, hey, we out here, we're doing big things.
Maybe even some hear video. From us?
That's awesome, even better.
Yeah once maybe if the sports job team gets bigger,
hey, that's right.
we can get some video. Yeah, I know, we're all just honestly I know Kate and I are just having a good time with this, so we're doing whatever, of course. Whatever works and whatever we can do. If there's a new thing we can add, you know, I'm all ears. Kate's all ears, I would assume. I don't want to say, but but yeah, I mean, all just over having a good time.
Dakota, can you talk about, of course, how you designed your logo?
Yeah, so my dad he's a graphics guy. He used to do like illustration. So him and I were just kind of talking, like I did the what's it called, we had a logo beforehand that may have been released, I don't know, but it wasn't the best logo, I'll give it, I'll be honest. It was a pretty half-butted logo, but But yeah, and so then I was just like, you know, like I really started to think and talk with him, like what the true like core value, like not core values, but like what goes into a logo. And so, you know, with the logo we have, it's half of a mic for the podcast and then half of a like pinhead or penhead. I don't know, it's pen tip. But it was like a one of those pens that you dip in ink, like old timey. And so that's the two halves. And then the bottom of it is like an audio wave. One side of it is like a plug that you plug in, like a mic plug. And then the other half is over a dotted line and it's like a signature. And so I really just tried to bring the two things of the podcast, A, podcast, and B, like signing your rookie contract. So yeah, I mean, it was kind of just me messing around with Photoshop and eventually I was happy enough with it where I was like, you know what? All right, here's the logo. What do you guys think? And I mean, Kate and Colby have been really helpful with, you know, anything. If I have an idea, I'll send it to them. We just started a group chat, no big deal, but now we're able to kind of bounce more ideas off of each other and, you know, they're absolutely two people that have helped along the path for sure.
Hey, can you talk about what advice would you give upcoming future podcasts looking to get started?
Yes, I say go for it. You know, what do you got to lose? Like, I had no idea what it took to build a podcast, what all that. But I say if you have, you know, the drive to do a podcast, talk to people, whatever, beyond sports, business, music. I mean, I've talked to people in the music arena and I was like, okay, that's cool.
Yeah, they-
and so, I mean, everyone has different interests, right? So it's super cool to hear from people, whatever it is. And if someone has that same drive, I say go for it. What do you got to lose? Mm-hmm. There's so many different areas to actually incorporate, and it's basically free. So you can just start chatting and do it.
Yeah.
Dakota, do you have any advice for any future sports podcasts?
All right. I'm excited you asked me that, Brandon. So yeah, I have a couple of pieces of advice. One of them I'm going to absolutely just 100% steal from Richard Hoke's episode. It actually personally took me out of a little rut. I was getting some rejection letters and I was just like, dude, what? Like, why? But so Richard in his episode, he said, dang, I said I was going to do 100%, but I'll do like 90%. Basically, it was like out of the sea of no's that you get. And as he quoted, there are a sea of no's. You know, one yes could change your life. So, you know, being persistent. Again, I'm going to steal another thing from an episode we had with Jenny Fisher. She's another one of the all-timers. But it was just keep showing up. You know, I have a shirt over here that she made, and she kind of helped distribute to bring awareness to like suicide prevention and, you know, awareness. And so I think that those three words can be kind of used in anything, you know, whether it be personally, keep showing up personally, that will help you, you know, it's all a domino effect. So if you're struggling personally, it's going to be hard for you to flourish, you know, in your career. So I think you have to keep a good balance of everything. And then the third thing I would say is, you know, as a LinkedIn connoisseur, if you will, make meaningful connections. Because like, yeah, I think if you go based solely off networking, I don't know how far you'll get. But if you have a very good balance of, you know, good expertise, good work, good skills, and a really good network, it's going to be hard for you to not get a job. It's going to be really hard for you to not, you know, go into the career that you want, go into the field that you want, because not only do you have good skills, but you have a good network that you can kind of give those skills to. And people love helping people out. At least I do, at least Kate does, at least, you know, the people that I know. So, I mean, if I were to see, I basically put myself in the shoes of, if I see someone that has skills and has, you know, a good network, I think that goes a good amount of way, then they're set. they're good. They're ready to kind of take the world on. So just those three things of keep showing up, make meaningful connections, and do not get worried about all of the no's, because it only takes one yes.
That's wonderful advice. Where can my listeners find your podcast at on social media, along with podcast platforms?
Ooh, yes.
They can find us on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Anchor.
You're on everything, guys.
Breaker, a few others. We have a link tree in our bio of mostly everything. We're on LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram.
Underscore contract on Twitter.
Twitter, rookie underscore contract. Instagram, I believe, is at the rookie contract.
You got the cool name on Insta.
Yeah, they did. It was taken already on Twitter. So, but yeah, I mean, we're everywhere. We're trying to get as incorporated into everything as possible. We want to be a resource that people can find anywhere. So we are just really, I think maybe we'll start TikTok soon. I'm terrible at dancing, so I would need to find a different type of thing to do. But yeah, I mean, like, honestly, as long as if they Google the rookie contract, I would hope that we have enough cred to make it up onto the first or second page of somewhere. But in all seriousness, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, and then basically anywhere you listen to podcasts.
Thank you again, Dakota and Kate, for your interview, and best of luck in your podcast, The Rookie Contract.
Thank you, Brandon. I appreciate you having the chance to give us a little spotlight. It's kind of cool to be on this side of it. You rock. I appreciate everything you're doing. Keep it up, and you're going to go places, man.
Thank you, Brandon. This has been super fun.
You can find Brandon Sports Talk on Facebook at Brandon Sports Talk, Instagram at Brandon Sports Talk, Twitter at @talk_Brandon, and you can find me on YouTube at Brandon Sports Talk. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you again, Kate and Dakota, for your interview, and best of luck in the rookie contract.
Thank you, Brandon.
You've been watching Brandon Sports Talk. Please feel free to like, share, and subscribe to Brandon Sports Talk on social media and on YouTube.